Hey golf people, if you've been watching the show this year, you know I tested a ton of equipment. We previously covered all the golf gear I use, and this is specifically golf technology. We are gonna cover my favorite launch monitors, virtual caddies, watches, rangefinders, and more. I got a chance to try just about everything, and this will give you some insights into what I really loved and what stuck around for me this year. Now for this list, budget is no option, because this year I tried everything from really inexpensive items all the way to the top of the line items. And I'm just going to present to you what I absolutely loved the most, no matter the price. Now I want to give a big thanks to our sponsor, playbetter.com, who supplied all the golf tech for me to try out this year. They've got free 48-hour shipping within the continental United States. They have the best return policy. It's a hassle-free 30-day policy. In fact, they've extended it here for the holidays all the way till January 31st, 2022. And on top of it, they're just awesome golf people who love the game with the best prices on the internet to boot. I will leave some links down below if you want to explore further any of the items we talk about here today. And of course, if you buy those, you do help support this show. Holy smokes, I tried a lot of rangefinders in 2021. I tried everything from the cheapest all the way up to the most expensive that you can possibly buy. And there's a big range in quality from rangefinder to rangefinder, which I found out, not only in terms of accuracy, but in terms of feature set. And the rangefinder that I thought did it the best this year was the Voice Caddie SL2. This thing is next level. What I loved most about this is the screen on the back. The Garmin Z82 has it in the viewfinder, and when you're looking through, you're actually looking through a camera. Whereas looking through this one, you're actually seeing the optical picture. It's like you're looking through a binocular or a standard rangefinder. And then all of the cool next level things are here on this back screen. Some of my favorite on-screen features include hole-by-hole flyovers. It also shows you the slope of the green, so you can see where the ball will fall off on that green once you hit it in different places. This thing is super awesome. Apparently they're huge in Korea. That's what people told me in the comments. And I think if you watch this video and you give this thing a try, this thing will get huge here in the United States and the UK and other places as well. This is one awesome piece of tech. One of my favorite pieces of technology all year, not just rangefinders, but certainly my favorite rangefinder of the year, the SL2 from Voice Caddie. Now, if you're a big fan of this channel, you know that I'm a watch guy. I'm always wearing a watch on my wrist, and that's why I really like to look at golf smartwatches. I geek out about them. My winner this year is the Garmin S42. Some of the best features of this watch include being able to track the distances that you hit your clubs, getting a full overview of all of the different hazards and things to know about on each hole, access to 42,000 courses, and really accurate GPS distances. It's super comfortable. You don't even feel it when you're swinging a golf club, and this screen is so nice and bright. There's also some other upgrades here with the S42 that you won't even get on the S62. It's definitely a faster performing watch. I think they did some operating system upgrades between the S62 and the S42 to make this thing even faster and better, and I absolutely love it. This is the smartwatch to get for me and the best one that I tried all year. If you've watched this show, or probably if you've become a channel subscriber, it's most likely due to the video that I did on the Garmin R10. So no surprise here, the R10 gets my vote. This thing is absolutely amazing in terms of both price point and feature set. To be able to get an entire course simulator, 42,000 courses, once again, that Garmin has mapped, built into a very accurate launch monitor for both outdoor and indoor use. At this price point, the Garmin R10 absolutely wins. The biggest drawback of this particular piece of golf technology is actually getting your hands on it, because it has been on back order since it was released. And I know people that ordered in the fall are still waiting for this thing in the spring, which is unfortunate, but I do think that's going to change here very soon, and you'll see a lot more of these available on the market. But by and far, testing everything from the Mevo to the Swing Caddie to the Rapsodo and everything in between, the Garmin R10 was the king of the hill this year for me. A huge trend in golf is and will continue to be a virtual caddy. Whether you're using an app, a smartwatch, or even those screw-in tabs into a dedicated system, this stuff is pretty next level. For me, the company that's doing it best in terms of compiling the data, in terms of performance and making sure that all the shots are recorded or as many as possible are recorded, and just the user experience, for me is the Arcos Caddy. You can see this little tab screwed into the butt end of my clubs, and what that does is send the data back to an app. I did an entire video demo walkthrough showing how this works, which I highly recommend you check out after you watch this video, but just a really cool system. And if you are looking to really hone in on your distances, improve your game, and get critical data that will help you improve and show you where the weaknesses and strengths in your game are, I highly recommend you take a look at the Arcos Caddy. If you've bought any clubs like a Cobra or a Ping this year, you likely have one of these already built into the grip of your club, and then you can just contact Arcos and have them send you the tabs for the other 13 and get into the system. It's really cool once you're in there. In terms of a virtual caddy, this is the best one that I tried this year. All right, the final category here is golf push carts slash trolleys. Depending on where you live, you might call it differently. But basically, when I'm out walking, I like to have a cart to have my golf clubs in rather than carrying a bag. And the next level upgrade that I got for a little bit of this year at least was the MGI Zip Navigator. This electrified trolley carried my bags for me and allowed me to experience the game of golf in an even more relaxing way because I didn't have to worry about my clubs. I just literally had a remote control where I showed it where to go. It was easy to navigate hills, both uphill and downhill, and it was just a blast to play with. I was actually bummed when I had to return that back to MGI after we were done testing it. I need to get one of these things for myself in 2022. They're definitely not cheap, but I think if you're doing a lot of walking, and especially if you're getting up there in age, or if you've got any health problems like I'm going through right now with my ankle, one of these things can be incredibly invaluable to you. And again, it just takes away one more barrier on playing and getting into the game, which is why the MGI Zip Navigator gets my vote for best golf cart slash push trolley of the year. So if you enjoyed this video, I highly recommend you go and check my favorite golf clubs and gear video where I broke down my favorite drivers, putters, irons, wedges, and a whole lot more. I'll also leave a video here to my favorite launch monitors of the year so you can find out which is the best choice for you. I hope you guys enjoyed this one, and I'll catch you back here very soon on another edition of Let's Play Through.